5 after 7, and I am back on the dusty trail. Feeling pretty good. After that big day, I wasn't sure how I would be feeling today, but I feel good. So that is good news. Last night I found the campsite. There were a group of guys there, but they were kind enough to let me camp with them. So that was nice. So yeah, had a nice night. And got my best night of sleep yet, thankfully. I needed it. So today is going to be an absolutely epic day. In a couple miles, maybe 2 or 3, I'll be on the top of Island Pass, which most people don't really consider it a pass, but I think the views from there are still supposed to be pretty great. And then after that is two of the big ones, Thousand Island Lakes and Garnet Lakes, or Garnet Lake, I think. So yeah, super excited, gonna spend some time there, take it a little bit more slowly today, and just enjoy. One nice thing about hiking this trail solo, especially in the mornings, is you see so much wildlife. I've seen so many families of deer and just individual deer. It's amazing. There's the Rush Creek trailhead where I was going to start if I couldn't get a permit out of Yosemite. It's one of the closest to Yosemite. So I went over Island Pass and didn't realize that what most people say happens. There's no like peak. But man, it is beautiful because, I mean, all around, every direction is beautiful, but I am just fixated on Banner Peak. How could I not be? Look at that. So this is where the PCT and the JMT split for a little while. The PCT goes that way, and the JMT goes that way. And I am going to go a few feet this way for now to take a swim. That was an incredibly successful stop at Thousand Island Lakes. I cleaned a shirt and took a dip. So I am feeling good. Time to head to Garnet Lake. Only about a quarter mile past Thousand Island Lakes. This is Emerald Lake. Maybe a quarter mile past the last lake. This is Ruby Lake. The color of that water. Approaching Garnet Lake. trail does much of the perimeter of Garnet. So lots of different vantage points. But I think this is my last one. It's been great. Are the minarets up there. This descent after the Well, there's a climb after Garnet. It's like a mini pass, and then this descent has just been unreal. First sight of Shadow Lake, and the color of that water just pops. Man. Perfect beach for a swim. Saying goodbye to the incredibly blue Shadow Lake. Quite a climb out of here. Coming up on Rosalie Lake. Campsites along here. Gladys or Gladys Lake, not sure how it's pronounced. A little cooler up here, feels good. Nice breeze, it has been hot today. I think this is my last lake for the day. It's been a day of just amazing lakes. Lots of relatively steep up and downs. And now I have a long descent, like 5 miles, down to what I think will be my campsite for the night. Unless I have trouble finding water there, then I would probably see about pushing to Reds, but we'll see how it goes. I'm just gonna enjoy this for a couple more minutes and then start the long, well, first I have a steep little climb up and then a long descent down, so. All right, here we go. It's a nice flat trail. It seems it's been a little while since I've had it. Feels good. I was mistaken about Gladys being the last lake. One right here. There's another little lake down there with some great campsites. This one is called Trinity Lakes. I have only passed one other hiker since Shadow Lake. And that was a long time ago. Weird. There were so many people that, you know, around Garnet, and now nobody's out here. It's crazy. You're in the land of giant trees. Big question for tonight, as far as my campsite goes, is whether or not there's going to be water there. I've heard some mixed reviews. I have an okay amount of water. So yeah, I'm just going to check it out when I get there. Could always do another, I think, 3.8 to Reds Meadow. Johnson Lake covered in algae, so I'm gonna pass on that. Head to Reds Meadow. Oh, hey, there's Mammoth Mountain. Cool. Ooh. Check it out. I am entering Devil's Post Pile National Monument. Leaving in your national forest and continuing onwards. A few more miles to Reds. This is where the JMT and PCT rejoin again. There's the Devil's Post Pile. Interesting. I'm about 0.9, just a little bit after 6. At long last, I am at the junction. So I think it's about 0.3 to the Meadow, Reds Meadow. tonight. I'm headed down there. Ultimately, I'm headed there. 57 miles down, 165 to go. So I'm here at Red's Meadow at the Backpackers Camp. Yeah, I'll check in tomorrow. Good night.